Previously, Ceres got a message from Poppy just as Nothorn was getting ready to head back to Bronbog and put their plan in motion. She let Ceres know that Ballora was going to be arriving back in Amon the next day, and that time was essentially up. Ceres passed that information along to the others, and then they headed back towards the town. They came across two lizardfolk guards as they got close, both of whom were taken out quickly by Ceres, Aerith, and Arian. Then Arian and Ceres slipped off from the others, heading to the far side of the town, while everyone else prepared to cause a distraction. After an impressive set of double nat ones for Iridian's stealth roll, Aerith had Zalar go ahead and turn her into a T-Rex with raven black feathers. She roared loudly and started rushing towards the town, with Gwei riding on her back, gaining everyone's attention, while Iridian and Zalar flew behind them on a pegasus summoned by Gwei. Meanwhile, Arian and Ceres crept quietly up to the other side of the town and turned invisible. The townspeople, being held prisoner, were spread out around the area and chained to the ground, presumably to create chaos and confusion. Ceres slipped back and forth, silently murdering unsuspecting enemies and picking locks to free as many of the villagers as she could. The others fought the multitude of lizardfolk, Yanti, and associated creatures. During the fight, both Aerith and Gwei gained temporary madness from the venom of one of the giant snakes slithering around, but Iridian luckily had sent Ava to stay near them, so he was able to cast Lesser Restoration from a distance. While a large number of townsfolk were killed by lizardfolk once they realized everything was going south, Ceres was able to free several of them, and the rest of Nothrum took out the enemies before they could kill everyone. In the aftermath of the fight, Zalar found some escape tunnels that Aerith helped cave in. Then, while the townsfolk burned their dead, Ceres got another message from Poppy saying that she expected Ballora would be willing to wait 48 hours at the most before they set out for the Abyss. Ceres let the others know, and they started to discuss their options. Arian and Aerith wanted to go to the Feywild as planned, but everyone else leaned towards the Abyss, especially once Aerith mentioned the potential time dilation related to the Feywild. The group and the remaining villagers left the town, heading back to where Nothrum had previously rested to set up camp. Once there, Zalar settled in to cast Contact Other Plane, while Aerith used her disguise kit to make herself look like her oldest sister. Zalar was able to find out that Arian's sister and nephew didn't seem to be in immediate danger, and the odds were against the group succeeding in the Abyss if everyone didn't go. As Zalar went to set up the hut, Iridian scried on Aerith's sister, who he found in Whitestone. He told Aerith what he saw, which had the potential to shift some of Nothrum's plans. And that's where we left off.